Hey guys, how are you doing? My name is Izzat and now I'm making a video on topic how to understand more in English language by listening. So I've prepared 4 tips for you. So now I'm immediately moving to the first tip, right? So there is nothing more to talk about. So the first thing is vocabulary. So you should learn vocabulary. Learning vocabulary, it doesn't really mean having tons of words, tons of synonyms and antonyms in your brain without knowing how to use them. So you should of course know synonyms, antonyms, and first thing that you should do is knowing all the meanings of the word, exact word. For example, word set has got more than 30 meanings. So you should be able to understand each and every meaning use of that word, yeah? And synonyms, I've already told that, and the pronunciation. Maybe you've been practicing English language in American pronunciation or British pronunciation, I mean the listening, yeah? But we've got a lot of kind of pronunciations. For example, Irish, Indian, American, British, Australian, Canadian. So you should be able to understand the same word in any pronunciation. In any pronunciation. Because in IELTS listening, for example, we are talking about that. So in IELTS listening, you will not have only one type of pronunciation. You will not hear only the American or only the British accents. You will be listening to a lot of kinds of pronunciations and accents. So you should be able to understand each and every one of them. So another tip is practice more. Practicing more, it doesn't really mean printing out tons of practice tests or IELTS materials and so on. Just when you are practicing, you should be able to analyze what kind of mistakes you've done. You should endure re-listening to the same audio again and again and again and again and analyze what kind of mistakes you've made and why have you made those mistakes. You should be able to do the same. So as for the practicing more with another kinds of stuff, so for example, I've got the first songs, English songs, for example the Eminem, yeah? You should be able to at least tend to understand the not each and every word. I think even native English speakers do not understand each and every word of Eminem songs, but the sentences or the general meaning of the song, just you should be able to at least try to imitate the same way of singing, yeah? So the first one was songs, I mean about practicing. And another one can be podcasts. We've got a lot of kinds of podcasts, for example, BBC News and 6 Minute English, yeah? So they can, of course, really help you. They can really help you because they will be talking on different kinds of topics and you will be understanding not only the way of academic English, but you will be able to understand more on the way of general English. Because as in IELTS listening, they will not be just talking about maps. They will not be talking about the multiple choices. They will not be talking about the topics, university life or customer service and so on. They will be talking about different kinds of topics every time, not repeatedly the same again. Yeah. So another one can be movies. Watch movies. If your level is around B1 or B2 in English language, I would better suggest you watch movies without subtitles. But if you are on a level of A1, A2, I do still recommend you watching movies, but with subtitles, yeah? So that you would not get frustrated about learning English without understanding the sentences of English language, yeah? So another tip, the third tip is pay attention on what you hear. Pay attention. When you are listening to the examiner, for example, the speaking module, or the speaker. When you are having a speaking module, you can ask to repeat the question. Yep, you can ask. That's not any kind of mistake that doesn't really play a role on decreasing your oral mark of speaking module. Yeah, you can ask to repeat the same question or to explain it with another way. Yeah, but as for the listening, unfortunately, we cannot be asking to replay the audio. Yeah, so that's why we should be doing what? We should not be thinking about anything. For example, when you are thinking, it means some kind of chat you are having with yourself in your head, yeah? Inside the brain. And outside the brain, there's being played a same conversation, yeah? And when there are two conversations going on, you cannot be able to pay attention on the imperative one of them. So that's why just do not think about anything, your personal life or any other stuff, yeah? Just forget about your life, forget about your experiences, forget who you are, where you are, what you are. Just pay attention on what you hear and try to catch each and every word. And the last tip is don't be afraid. Never be afraid. Never be afraid. Just never think that you will lose something else if you get just a lower band and IELTS listening or just the overall. Never be afraid if you skip some answers of the listening. Just try to pay attention on what you hear as much as you can. Just do your best, yeah? Don't be afraid, because you are doing the same thing in English language that you do in your daily life, in your native, in your own language, yeah? So that's why don't be afraid of anything while leaving them. And pay attention on what you hear. Don't think about anything. Practice more with songs, podcasts, and movies. And learn vocabularies with synonyms, antonyms, with the meanings, with all the meanings, and all kinds of pronunciations you should know about a word what you are learning, yeah? So these are my tips for you. This is how have I taken 8 from IELTS listening, yeah?